Hello students, in this video we are going to see packing in crystal. We have studied crystalline solids, amorphous solids. So in crystal, its constituents, how packed, that we are going to discuss today. So how to relate the packing of crystal? If you go to fruit stall, we can see the fruits may arranged in closed packed arrangement. How it may be arranged? Even in sweet stall, laddu, we can see like this arrangement. First one row, in the disposition of the row, second row may be present. Likewise, we can see this triangle shape in three-dimensional structure. Why they are using like this arrangement? Within small area, they can able to keep more amount of laddu or fruits. So the same arrangement we can compare with packing in crystal. So within short area, how maximum we can pack the constituent ions. So in this video we are going to discuss packing of crystal. See, why we want to find the maximum closely packed arrangement in crystal? Because the force of attraction between the constituents should be maximized to maximize the attractive force. Between constituents, if you want to make the attraction between the constituent maximum, we should go with closely packed arrangement. So in crystals, we are going to discuss how the constituents are arranged in closely packed arrangement. In this portion, we can discuss the atoms or constituents as a hard spheres. We can assume, because we cannot always tell atoms, constituent, ions or molecules. If you take any crystal, that crystal may be made up of atoms or it may be ions like cation, anion, or it may be a neutral molecule or polar molecule. So to tell the constituent atom, constituent ion or neutral molecule, we can use the word spheres. We are considering atoms like spheres, because in the previous video itself we have studied. Simply we cannot explain all the three-dimensional structure of crystals. Only we can draw in the board two-dimensional. So due to that, the atom or ion, neutral molecules consider as a spheres. So hereafter, spheres arranged means that indicates a constituent atom or ion or neutral molecules of crystal. Right. So we can discuss the three-dimensional arrangement of crystal as well as two-dimensional arrangement of crystal by understanding the atoms as a spheres. Let us go with simple arrangement to understand clearly three-dimensional structure. So first we can discuss linear arrangement of spheres in one direction. So linear. Linear means what? Line. So only one direction we have the arrangement. How we can draw the arrangement? Only one direction. In linear, like straight line structure, if you draw, that is only called linear arrangement of spheres in one direction. All the spheres in only one direction as a linear structure, if you draw, this is a basic arrangement. In that, each sphere contact with two neighbors. If you take any one sphere, for example, I am taking this sphere. For this sphere, if you count, how many number of spheres are attached with that one? One, two. So, two spheres are attached with middle one. So, we can say in the linear arrangement, all the constituent spheres are touching with or connected with two neighboring spheres in either side. So, not in the same side. On either side, each one sphere is connected with or contact with the middle sphere. So, this is a basic arrangement, linear arrangement of spheres in one direction. We can say one dimensional, because only one direction. We have taken one direction. Let us go with two dimensional close packing. Two-dimensional closed packing. So, what do you mean two-dimensional closed packing? The same linear arrangement, if you continue in two-dimensional or two-direction, we can say that is two-dimensional closed packing arrangement. This two-dimensional arrangement divided into two types. One is AA type, another one is ABAB type. So, first we will discuss AAA type. What do you mean AAA type? Actually, it is continuing. So, you take one linear arrangement. Okay, sir. So, we studied first type, you know, simplest arrangement, linear arrangement. This linear arrangement, if you continue as a next row, means we can say that is AA type. How, sir? The same, you consider this A row. The same identical row, we can take as a next row. But here you have to listen. The identical spheres are aligned similar with the first row. They are aligned in same position. So, one row we can consider A. The next row, which is identical with first one. So, the second one also we can say another A. If you take one more row, we can take upwards or downwards. But the condition is, it should be aligned in the same arrangement. How? If you see vertically or horizontally, it should be aligned. See? In vertical or horizontal manner, if you see, all the spheres are arranged same arrangement. So this is only forming AAA type arrangement. See, one dimensional arrangement, if you take more number of rows, it becoming two dimensional with AA type arrangement. So just I am repeating, if you take only this row, we can say that is linear arrangement. That linear arrangement row, if you take two or more numbers, it becoming two dimensional closed packing. In the two dimensional closed packing, which is aligned, all the rows aligned in same or identical horizontal and vertical arrangement, that is only forming AAA type or AA type. Very important, my dear students. The spheres of different rows align vertically as well as horizontally. If you take vertically, if you see same line, same alignment. At the same time, if you see horizontally, that is also same type of arrangement, same alignment. This kind of alignment makes this type of AAA type arrangement. See, first row we can say A. The second row also identical with the first row. So we can give name for second row also A. Third row, the similar with the first row. So all are A. That's why this type of arrangement we can say AAA, it is continuing. So both sides we can extend. That's why this same arrangement we can extend vertically. At the same time horizontally, here also we can extend, no problem. So as a plane or as a layer, we can extend in two dimensional. This arrangement only called AA type arrangement. So we can see all the rows are identical with adjacent rows. Let us calculate each sphere in this arrangement contact with four neighbor spheres. See, if you take this one, how many spheres are contact or connected with this sphere? 1, 2, 3, 4. So how many neighbors are contact with the sphere? 4. Next type, AB type. What do you mean AB type? Here also we are going to take one linear arrangement with identical spheres. Okay. The second row, this first row we can name A row. The second row occupies the dispersion of the first row. What do you mean dispersion? Sorry, depression. Depression of the first row. In between the spheres, we have the small gap, you know, that is only called depression. So, the depression of the first row, we can continue the second row. First row is different from second row, so we can name the second row B. Next, third row, which is identical with first row. See, these are vertically aligned, right? So the third row is similar with first row. So third row also we can name again A. Then fourth row. fourth row is similar with the second row. The depression, sorry, yes, depression we have to draw. What do you mean depression? The gaps between the spear. Okay, for differentiation I am giving red color for B rows. So in AAA type, all the rows identical and also horizontally and vertically aligned. But in same two dimensional, the second type AB type, one row horizontally arranged, the next row which is not vertical or similar to the first row, in the gaps between the spear, second row spears are arranged, or in the disposition of first row, second row is placed. The third row which is identical with first one. So first row A means third row also we can name A. Second row if you name B, which is similar with what? Fourth row. So fourth row also we can name B. The same arrangement we can extend in two dimensional directions. We can again continue another A. See, actually I explain first row is present, the second row present the depression of the first row. If you see clearly, the third row, if you see, which is placed depression of the second row. See, in between these two spear, the third one is present. So one, if you take as a first row, second row will be present the depression of the first row. Third row will be identical with the first row. Fourth row is identical with the second row. So now AB rows are alternatively arranged. This is only called AB type arrangement. See, each spear contact with six neighboring spears. You take any one spear. Shall I take this one? Yes. I am marking X. This spear connected with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this spear, or each spear in AB type, contact with six neighboring spears. Okay, if you compare in two dimensional closed packing of crystal, which is more closely packed arrangement, either AAA type or ABAB type, which is more closely packed, even you can say in fruit stalls they are following ABAB type, so that is only more closely packed. So very important, if you compare AB type with AAA type, AB type only more closely packed in arrangement. Now we have completed with two dimensional closed packing. Let us take three dimensional closed packing. So if you go with three dimensional, we can go with particular arrangement or simple body center, like we can go with geometry level arrangement. So three dimensional closed packing we are going to see. In that, first we are going to see simple cubic arrangement. Actually, in your book, they are not separately given as a three-dimensional closed packing. Actually, which comes under the three-dimensional packing arrangement. Okay, for simple cubic arrangement, how the spheres are arranged. For simple cubic arrangement, we can take the same two dimensional arrangement, AAA type. The two dimensional arrangement, if you take it for three dimensional, we will get simple cubic arrangement. Sir, what sir? Two dimensional arrangement means what? For AAA type, first row is there na, the second row also identical or horizontally and vertically aligned. You can take one more. See, all three rows are identical. All are similar. So we can say AAA type. Right. This AA type, now we can continue upwards or downwards or left side or right side. We can extend. But that is called two dimensional arrangement. If you draw axis, x axis, y axis. So this is minus x, this is minus y. This arrangement you can extend with plus y axis or minus y axis. If you draw one more row upwards, we can extend in the y direction. Or if you draw one more row in the bottom, we can extend in the minus y direction. Sir, I am increasing the length of this diagram, this side. So minus x we can develop or plus x we can develop. So only two dimensional arrangement, only two direction we are extending. Now if you take x, y, z axis, what will happen? Now you consider all these rows are arranged in this book. Okay, so in this book you just consider all the rows are present. First row, second row, third row, all are identical. So this is AAA type. Now I can extend right, left side or front, back side. There are one more possibility. There is a one layer. The upper or above to this layer, I can arrange one more layer. So the third axis, that means in the z axis also, I am increasing the both downward as well as upward. If you increase the layer, that is only becoming three dimensional closed packing. See, the same two dimensional packing, the same arrangement. Spheres are identical, all rows are identical, they are aligned horizontally as well as vertically. Now the additional point is, in this layer you consider one layer. In the front side, you can arrange some more sphere in the above to this rows, like in fruit stall. So in the fruit stall, what will happen? We can see the fruits are arranged in the layer wise. One layer in the bottom, another layer in the next layer, like first row, second row, third row becoming separate layers. So all the layers bringing the three dimensional arrangement. So like that, if you see, that is AAA type, that is only forming simple cubic arrangement. So in the simple cubic arrangement, spheres are arranged in vertically as well as horizontally in identical manner. Let us count number of neighboring spheres. First, you choose any one sphere. I am choosing this one. How many spheres are connected or contact with that sphere? Right? This sphere connected with this one. See, they are not connected. Because only in the depression only they may connected, but they are not depressly arranged. They are AAA type. So this diagonally placed sphere not connected with the sphere. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Over are only 4. Not like that. Now the fifth one is above to this sphere. The sixth one is below to this sphere. So you just imagine in a sweet stall, laddu is arranged in this three-dimensional arrangement. If you see one laddu in the middle, totally 6 other laddus are contact with that laddu. How? 4 is surrounded in the same layer, 1 in the above to this layer, the same layer, below one layer, above one layer you consider. So in the above layer, which sphere is directly above to this, that is fifth one, directly below to this sphere becoming sixth one. So each sphere in simple cubic arrangement contact with 6 neighboring spheres. Let us find the packing efficiency in simple cubic arrangement. What even packing efficiency? See, we have to find packing fraction or packing efficiency. Packing efficiency or packing fraction, straight away we cannot find. Why? There is a spree phase. You just imagine the spheres. Cubic means one layer, the second layer, third layer, all are identical. Okay. Now you can see the gaps or free phase between the spheres. So we cannot say, if you take one crystal, all the space occupied by the atom or molecules, we cannot say, because there is a gaps or free space between the sphere. We have to remove or we have to subtract the space, then only we can say it's a packing efficiency. So due to that gaps, we have to follow the packing efficiency formula to find packing efficiency. So the percentage of total volume occupied by constant spheres we can find by using packing efficiency arrangement. If you take overall volume, we can find, but actually all the overall volume does not occupied by the spheres. There are gaps between the spheres. So we have to subtract the gaps, or only we have to find volume of the spheres. So volume of the sphere, then number of sphere in the crystal, if you find, we can find the packing fraction. Listen carefully. We want to find packing fraction or packing efficiency. Now this is a crystal. In the crystal, constant ions are present as a spheres. So how many spheres are present? For example, 100 we can take. Then each sphere occupying how many volume? That I can write V. So if you multiply this, we can get packing efficiency of this crystal. Let us write the formula to find packing efficiency for simple cubic arrangement. The packing fraction is equal to total volume occupied by spheres in a unit cell. For unit cell we are calculating. For one unit cell, how many spheres present? That spheres occupied volume. That is only total volume occupied by spheres in a unit cell. Because we cannot take crystal. Crystal means we have to tell what is the length of the crystal, what is the breadth of the crystal. So per unit cell, if you find, we can calculate per crystal. Based on the crystal size, we can calculate. So for unit cell, we are calculating total volumes occupied by spheres in a unit cell, which is divided by volume of a unit cell. So total volume of the unit cell, spheres occupied volume of the unit cell. If you know, we can find packing efficiency. In percentage, we have to calculate. So we can multiply with 100. Okay, apply the values. How do you find the total volume occupied by the spheres in unit cell? Let us take, what is the volume of cube? How do you find the volume of cube? What's the formula to find volume? A for cube means A. So becoming A cube. So you know unit cell, simple cubic arrangement only we are studying. So we have cubic arrangement. So cubic means one unit cell considers one cube. So all the directions, all the length becoming, edge length becoming same. A, B, C values are same. So we can take all are A. So it becoming A3. So volume of unit cell is nothing but A3. We have calculated. Now there is a small problem. We have found only volume of cube. For each sphere, we have to find volume. How will you find each sphere? For that, we have to take one diagram. In your book, that is clearly given. You know, each corner in simple cubic, we have the spheres. But that sphere is common for 8 unit cells. So 1 by 8 portion only applicable for this unit cell. So 1 by 8 portion I am drawing. Okay. Now you see there are 8 portions. Now what's the length of this unit cell? A. So A is length. The total length shared by 2 spheres. Actually, if you see in the book, it is clearly explained. Look at the diagram in page number 187. See this diagram. In this diagram, see, each corner we have the spheres, but only 1 by 8 portion is applicable for this taken unit cell. Now, the total length of the unit cell A is shared by 2 spheres. So, we need radius of 1 sphere. So, total length is A means that is shared with 2 spheres. So, 2, the A is nothing but 2R. How it becoming 2R? 1 sphere radius R. So, 2 sphere only shared, forming the length of unit cell A. So, what is R value? R is equal to A by 2. So, now the radius of sphere we have found. Why sir, we have to find the radius of sphere? If you know volume of one sphere, we can calculate total volume of that unit cell. So, let us find the packing efficiency. R is equal to A by 2. R value we have found. Now, apply in the formula. What is the formula to find volume of the sphere? Volume of the sphere is nothing but 4 by 3 by R cube. Now, what is R value? A by 2. So, apply R value A by 2 whole cube. Simplify this one. 4 by 3 by A cube by 2 into 2 into 2, 8. 4 2s. Then by A3 divided by 6. Now volume of one sphere we have found. Total volume of occupied by the spheres in simple cubic unit cell for one sphere, volume is this one. Now we have to find total volume of volume occupied by spheres in a unit cell. If you take one unit cell, how many spheres or how many atom per unit cell? Already we have studied. For simple SC, simple cubic unit cell, the number of atom per simple cubic unit cell is nothing but 1. So this value we can multiply with 1. So the same we will get. Can you catch that? How it becoming 1? We know NC divided by 8. 8 by 8 is equal to 1, like we found in the previous video. Okay, now we will find the packing fraction. What's the formula for packing fraction? Total volume occupied by spheres in a unit cell. That is nothing but by A3 divided by 6. Then volume of unit cell. What is the volume of unit cell? Initially we found A cube. Now A cube may cancel, and also we have 100 for percentage calculation. 100 by divided by 6. What's the remaining? By is there, then 100. So we can write 100 by divided by 6 alone. A cube is cancelled. So what is the packing fraction? 100 by 6. So if you apply the by value 3.14 or 22 divided by 7, after simplification we will get 52.31%. So this is very important. What is the packing efficiency or packing fraction of simple cubic? Not for BCC. For BCC we are supposed to find. Okay, let us go with next type, body center cubic arrangement. For simple cubic arrangement only we have studied now. For BCC, body center cubic arrangement, we have to find the packing efficiency, everything. First discuss the arrangement. In simple cubic arrangement we have taken AAA type in three dimensional arrangement. For body center cubic arrangement we are going to take ABAB type. In ABAB type, how it may be arranged? If you take first row, the second row may be present in the depression of the first row. Again, third row becoming identical with first row. Fourth row is similar with second row. Right. How do you name for these rows? A, B, A, B. So this type only called AB type. Now you have formed first layer. Above to this first layer, we can keep another layer. So layer by layer, if you repeat in three dimensional arrangement, we will get body center cubic arrangement. Then count number of spheres contact with neighbors. You choose any one. May I choose this one? Okay. How many spears are connected with this spear? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Over? No. Two more we have to explain. How? This is one layer means below to this layer there is another layer. Above to this layer there is another layer. So there are one atom in the below the layer, one atom in the above to this layer. So totally 8 neighbor spears are contact with this each spear. So in body center cubic lattice, each spear connected with 8 other spears. Let us calculate packing efficiency for body center cubic. Packing efficiency or packing fraction. Now you have to look at the diagram deeply, then only you can calculate packing efficiency. Page number 188, we have this diagram. In this diagram we have many triangles. In that we have to take diagonal value 2 or value. For that I am going to take two triangles A, B, C. This triangle as well as A, C, G. This triangle. This two triangle I am going to take now. First triangle A, B, C. In A, B, C. Triangle ABC, apply Pythagoras theorem. We know that AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Apply square root both sides. If you apply square root, square will go out. So AC is equal to square root of AB square plus BC square. Now apply the value for AB and BC. AB is nothing but length of that unit cell A. So AB value is nothing but A square plus what is BC? BC also A square. So we are applying the length of unit cell AB, length A, BC length A. So AB square A square, BC square A square. Now we can simplify this one. How will you simplify? 1 A square, another A square, totally 2 A square, then 2 A, because square with square root means we can take A. A square with square root we can take it out A. So now the AC value we found, that is square root of square root A. Next we take another angle. Here we will write only AC value, square root with A. Then ACG angle, triangle we have to take. According to Pythagoras, AG squared is equal to AC squared plus CG squared. Now, as usual, apply square root in both direction, both side. So AG squared becoming AG square root of AC squared plus CG squared. What is AC squared? Just now we found square root A. Apply AC value, square root A whole square plus CG squared is nothing but A squared. Right? If you look at the diagram, we can see the distance only. The length CG, A value, CG squared, A squared. Now you have to simplify this one. So AG is equal to this one. You write two times square root into a square plus a square. Now anything two times in the square root we can take outside. Two times if you write square root we can write as a 2. Listen ma, square root into square root. Square root into square root is nothing but is equal to 2, because square root means half 2. So another half 2, half of becoming 1. So 2 power 1. So what will you get? 2 a square plus a square, totally 3 a square. Now the AG value is 3 a square. Now a square we can take it out as a a, root 3 a. So now AG value is root 3 a. Now we can bring the relation between radius. What is the radius? 4r. Totally we have 4r. Previously we have studied the AG is equal to 4r. Root 3a is equal to 4r. Now find r value. 4 sphere only give this value, that's why 4r. 1 sphere radius r, 4 sphere together only forming this value. So 4r, r is equal to what? Root 3 by 4 into a. Now only we found r value. Next we can find volume of the sphere. What is the formula for volume of the sphere? 4 by 3 by r cube. R value is root 3 by 4 a whole cube. 4 by 3 by root 3 we have to write thrice, then a cube divided by 4 cube. 1 4 1 cube 1 power you can reduce. Then 2 root 3 is equal to 1 3. What's the remaining? Root 3 by a cube divided by 4 squared. 4 squared is nothing but 16. So root 3 by a cube by 16 is the volume of sphere. For volume of one sphere we have found. Volume of one sphere, root 3 by a cube divided by 16. Now number of sphere per BCC unit cell is equal to 2. We can multiply with 2. So 1 time 8. So root 3 by a cube divided by 8. Now we can apply in the packing fraction formula. What is the packing fraction formula? Total volume occupied by the spheres in unit cell. That is only root 3 by a cube divided by 8. Packing efficiency or fraction. Volume occupied by, total volume occupied by the spheres in unit cell divided by volume of the unit cell a cube. For making percentage, we can multiply with 100. A cube will be cancelled. Then, we can write root 3 by into 100 divided by 8. Now how will you simplify? Root 3 value is 3.14. Then 8, if you divide, it becoming 12.5. Apply all the value. The final percentage is nothing but 68%. For simple cubic, we found 52.31. For body center cubic, 68%. Remaining we will see in the next video. Thank you.